Welcome back, students. So let's discuss about the body of this paragraph or the paragraph writing. In the previous video module, we have learnt that how to write introduction or what is expected in introduction of an analytical paragraph. Now coming to the body. Here, body, which is the main part of our writing, may contain in detail. We have to go here, but that is in brief. All the information, but in brief. See, now your body of the paragraph should contain all the information or the details. Contain the details. This is what. Next, it should include all the information, but the in brief, in short, because we have word limit, we need to follow. That is 100 to 120 words. See, next, here in body or in our main content, we need to choose some significant details, important details. No need to mention each and everything, only the significant details. Now, next, the body can be broken. Especially, I am talking about the main paragraph or the body. The body of your paragraph writing can be broken into two or three sub-paragraphs. You can do. It depending on the information which is provided to you or on the table. It depends on that. If you are going to break your paragraph in two or three sub-paragraphs there. For example, it happens sometimes if you explain 4 to 5 trends in the given table or in the given data or the chart, whatever. If you are explaining 4 to 5 trends, that time you can use one sub-paragraph for each trend here. That you can do. Because what will happen? It is best, especially it is good for the reader for understanding. If you are explaining one trend in one sub-paragraph. Then organizing information in your body. So what will you do here? Organize information that we need to look here for the prominent differences. Differences I wrote in brief here short. Right? Only the main prominent point that you need to mention here. Because for everything there is no space. Next, mention the smallest. So what is expected in the paragraph? Because the data or the chart outline which is given to you, that is definitely will be based on some information, maybe in the form of quantities or anything there, data. So you have to mention there the smallest or the largest. Try to find out what is the smallest thing and what is the largest. It means the prominent information. We need to look for the prominent one, aspects in the data. It means smallest one, largest one, similar point, contrasting point. So this one, smallest and largest in your body. Next, similar aspects should be also mentioned, should also be mentioned here. If we think there are some similar aspects plus there are some contrasting aspects, that similar plus contrasting aspects that should be mentioned. It means main prominent aspects. Next, if you think that there are some unchanged or constant aspects are there, that should also be mentioned. For example, the growth between these 2 years, for example 2001 to 2002, that is the growth is maintained, the similar, that is, it is unchanged or the constant, that also you can mention here, the main things. Next, now the comparing information. How will you compare the information here? Two differences. For example, the parties are given, two different parties are given. If you want to explain, if you want to describe, analyze what, if the data is about men and women, their ratio, their birth rate, death rate, whatever. Or regarding their improvement rate. So then it means that two different parties, that is, for example, if men and women is given, so that time how will you analyze then? So look for the contrast and the comparison. It means in your analytical paragraph that you should look for the contrast, comparison, smallest, largest, or such, or the changed, unchanged. So such points that you need to look here. Contrast and comparison could be drawn. Next, for example, if it highlights a particular time, if your data highlights, your chart highlights a particular time or several years, particular time or several years, so that time, in short, in brief, you can mention each year, that is in concise, in short, each year, if it is given in several years, or it shows, it highlights particular time, in that case. Then, mention quantities. Next, coming to the quantities. If your data table is given in the form of quantities, so what will you do there? For example, percentage, then the fraction, you can mention percentage and the ratios there. 35%, 40% ratios that you can mention. And you can also use some connecting sentences there. So, how will you describe then trends, or how will you mention the, especially the quantities? You can use the following phrases. For example, which I have mentioned here, because it is not possible to write each and everything on the board. See now, for describing quantities, this point in your body, your main paragraph, which phrases that you can use, or the words, example, compare quantities. For example, it was 48%, 50%, 60% of, then 1/3 of. You can use all these such phrases or the words. 1/3 of, nearly 1/4 of, almost 80%, majority, on average, twice as much. Such phrases you can use in quantities there. When you are mentioning the percentage, fractions, ratios there, almost equal, the highest, the lowest, smallest, very close to, this much percentage, 2%, 5 or the 10%, very much close to 2%, roughly, approximately 5% of, just under 3%. So in this way that you can go ahead, you can use different phrases there. Clear? And then connecting sentences. When we are connecting the sentences or establishing the contrast or the relationship, you can use the following phrases or the words. I am reading now. See, how will you use the phrases or the words for establishing relationship, connection? For example, relationship between, you can use start, then similarly, in contrast with, in comparison to, but in the opposite case, however, whereas, when it comes to, as opposed to, while, striking difference, noticeable difference. So in this way, children, you can use the various phrases or words, such words that you can use here. So children, in this way here, we have discussed in short about what the body of your analytical paragraph and what is expected here, which are the points that you need to mention. Clear? So now, children, only one is left, that is conclusion, that we will discuss in the next video module. Thank you, students.